Moving forward after a devastating fire, owners of a Springfield plywood mill announced plans to rebuild. Thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Matt Templeman.
I'm Renee McCullough. Fire swept through the Springfield plywood and veneer mill in July, leaving 250 people without jobs. KZI 9 News reporter Megan Higgins live tonight in Springfield to show us what's next. Megan.
Yeah, Matt, Renee, pretty hard to believe that just a few months ago, this site behind me here in Springfield was a thriving plywood mill. Right now, there's just burned out debris left behind from that massive fire back in July. But hope is on the way, bringing a new mill and jobs for hundreds.
After months of waiting and wondering, finally some good news for Springfield. Plans to rebuild a new plywood and veneer mill, not only bringing back workers, but also business to the area.
That would be amazing. I mean, we could definitely use the business.
Investigators blame a dryer fire for the massive fire in July that could be seen for miles. Firefighters worked through the night, putting out hot spots, and when it was over, a gutted building and hundreds without jobs. Since the fire, the mill's owner, Swanson Group, has worked hard to get back on its feet. And with help from insurance, the city, and a neighboring landowner, the company is confident of a comeback. Businesses couldn't be more pleased.
And having all those guys back there needing breakfast and lunch and coffee, that'd be great.
This is going to be something that's really going to lift a lot of people's spirits. So, and that needs to happen.
The goal is to start rebuilding in April or May and be back in production the following year, either late June or July of 2016. A steady process towards a new start and new jobs for many.
Now, of the 250 workers who were displaced by that fire, 43 took jobs at Swanson Mills down in the Douglas County area. They will return to this Springfield site once the mill is up and running. Overall, the company is planning on hiring an additional 200 workers. And get this, good news. That hiring could begin as early as November. Live in Springfield, Megan Higgins, KZI 9 News.